you want to be healthier, yet you just don't know what to do. All these shows telling you this and that, but nothing seems to work. Well, listen close. Golden State Media Concepts has got something great for you. The health and wellness podcast dedicated to workout trends, healthy eating habits, diet, and everything about healthy living. Join us in our banters as we help you not just live life to the fullest, but live it to the healthiest.
Hello and welcome to the GSMC Health and Wellness Podcast, brought to you by the GSMC Podcast Network. I am your host, Heidi, and sadly for me, we are not joined by Ariane today for this Health and Wellness Podcast, but it is okay. I promise that I will carry you all through because we are looking at a very interesting topic, at least one that is interesting to me. I feel like this is particularly interesting to me. Well, this would be interesting, I guess, if you were like a parent with like teenagers, but I am at that point in my life where I am not a teenager. I feel like sometimes I am viewed still as a teenager, but I am also young enough to kind of know what's going on with teens, mostly because of like social media. And I have noticed this weird thing, like vaping. Vaping is weird to me. The reason I find it kind of weird is because it looks like a USB drive, but it certainly doesn't taste like one. And people are just like putting it in their mouths and like you blow clouds of smoke and it looks like kind of cool. And people do like smoke rings and it's supposed to be better for you than smoking. And it's like supposed to just be water vapor. And then you kind of like walk around outside and you walk through like someone's like vape cloud that smells like cotton candy. And it's very strange and confusing. I want to know more about vaping. Is it good for you? Is it really better for you than smoking? And like, what is a vape pen? Why do they look like little tiny like USB drive things? But then you also get these bigger ones that look sort of like you're playing a piccolo. I don't understand, but that's why I am bringing you all this episode so that we can talk about it today. So, let me just start off by saying many teenagers are into vaping. I am not cool enough for that. I'm really just like a straight edge suburbanite. But also adults, like older people who are not teenagers, also vape. And as I mentioned, some of the reason that vaping was invented is people were hoping that it would help people quit smoking. You know, like you have the patch that you can use, like the nicotine patch or the gum. But this is supposed to be another device that is supposed to help people stop smoking cigarettes by using a vape pen. But other teenagers have caught on to vaping, and I'm probably because it smells good, like it smell like vanilla and cinnamon, and because it looks cool, because it looks like you're just like blowing out big clouds or fat clouds, as I'm sure some people say. And because I said that, I'm sure a lot of people tuned out because I said fat clouds, but that's okay. So we're going to get into it. So what is vaping? So known as the modern e-cigarette, it was invented in 2003 by Chinese pharmacist Han Lik, and it first sold in 2004. So this is pretty recent. It was invented in 2003, and China is still the biggest producer of vape pens, the biggest manufacturer, which is not surprising since they are the biggest manufacturer of everything. But it was invented in China by a Chinese pharmacist. They were sold a year after they were invented, 2004. But then e-cigarettes arrived in the U.S. in 2007. So other countries had had e-cigarettes before the U.S. did. And the vape pen to vape, as they say, is to inhale vapor. And that vapor is created from a liquid that is heated up inside the vape pen or the e-cigarette, however you want to call it. So inside the device, it has a mechanism that heats up the liquid, and then that turns into vapor. And then when you go to vape, you inhale that vapor, and then you will exhale it, which is why you see people blowing out these big clouds of, you know, vapor and steam and those kinds of things. It's why you end up walking through it by accident when you're just going outside and people are like on their smoke break. The reason I bring that up also is because when people are outside of like my office building smoking cigarettes, I try and avoid it because I can smell it. But if someone's just out there vaping and it smells like mint, I might not notice. And then when I'm not paying attention, someone will, you know, exhale all this vapor from their vape pen and I will just walk through a cloud and smell weird afterwards. I don't know if anyone else has had that problem. It happens to me a lot. So, speaking of the e-cigarette, it has many different names. So as I mentioned, there is vape pen, which is the one that I mostly know it by. There are also pod mods, tanks, electronic nicotine delivery devices, or the acronym ENDS, E-N-D-S, e-hookahs, and e-cigarettes. Within these devices, there is a liquid, which is what becomes the vapor, and that liquid can also contain, it also is like a lot of other, it has a lot of other names besides just like a liquid. So it can be called e-juice, e-liquid, cartridges, pods, or oil. And most vape liquids contain a combination of propylene glycol or glycerol, also called glycerin, as a base, and then nicotine. It can also have marijuana or flavoring chemicals to produce flavors. It can be anywhere from like mint, as I've mentioned, which is kind of a normal flavor, to like people have weird names for the flavors, like unicorn puke, which I can't even imagine what that tastes like slash smells like. So you are not actually just inhaling and exhaling water vapor if you vape. It's a, that wouldn't make any sense why just water vapor would help you quit smoking. There has to be something else in there. So it does contain often nicotine and these other flavoring agents, or it can contain marijuana as well. It doesn't have to contain nicotine. When it's like for people who are trying to quit, it does contain some nicotine in it. And when I see a lot of teenagers and they're smoking it, like 15-year-olds, I'm assuming they're not smoking nicotine, but I don't know. Like I used to work at a camp, and I went into some cabin for a family, and there was just some kid who looked like 13, but like preteen. So when boys are that young, you can't really tell if they're like 8 or like 14. It's really hard to tell. And he was just like sitting in the back, like vaping. And that was like a few years ago, so I didn't really know what it was. Again, I'm not that cool. And I was confused why there was like a child smoking in the wilderness in this cabin, and like his family didn't care. So I would assume if a child is smoking a vape pen, there's not actually nicotine in it. It's just like the flavorings. And then when they're doing that, it's just so that like they can blow the clouds and like make like smoke rings and things like that. I will try to make this podcast as informative as possible, but I have to say, I think it looks kind of stupid if you're doing it just for as I will say again, and more people will now tune out when I say it again, just so that you can make fat clouds, I think is kind of stupid. Or if you've seen the YouTube video of some guy who is going to go vape and get these big vape clouds and trying to do all the tricks where you can like exhale vapor and then you like put your hand through it and you can like push clouds, like it looks like a magic trick. It's very funny because he doesn't actually do any of it. He just tries really hard. So there you go. That's a glimpse of my humor. But anyway, so as I said, these vape liquids contain other mixtures in it, not just water. It's not just water vapor that you were inhaling and exhaling. The e-cigarette to create an aerosol or a vapor is its exact composition can vary. So the liquid that's inside the e-juice or the e-liquid, it can be all these components, but there can be other things in it. Like as I mentioned, it doesn't have to contain nicotine, it doesn't have to contain marijuana, it can have different flavorings, different scents. So because of that, the liquid is not going to be the same in every vape pen that you come across or in every like pod that you buy. They can vary. And that's not just based on flavorings, that can be other compounds as well. So the majority of toxic chemicals that are found in tobacco smoke are usually absent in e-cigarette aerosols, and those present are mostly below 1% of the corresponding levels in tobacco smoke, and the aerosol can contain toxicants and traces of heavy metals at levels that are permissible in inhalant medications. And also potentially harmful chemicals not found in tobacco smoke at concentrations permissible by workplace safety standards. So what that means is there is an argument that vaping is better for you than if you were just to smoke traditional cigarettes. So what they're trying to say is the majority of toxic chemicals that are in tobacco smoke can be absent from e-cigarette aerosols. And the toxic chemicals that are present are below the 1% of the corresponding levels in tobacco smoke. And the aerosol can contain toxicants and traces of heavy metals, but those are at levels that are permissible in like other inhalant medications and things like that. And potentially harmful chemicals are not found in tobacco smoke at concentrations that are permissible. And also these go by workplace safety standards. So it's not like you are allowed to like smoke outside of an office building with a vape pen. They're not trying to say that the toxic chemicals are far too high for like public use, which is why you'll see people like vaping at like a restaurant that has an outdoor patio, because they do pass safety standards. So they're considered okay. And they're considered safe for those around them. Which, yeah, I don't know. I think it still kind of looks obnoxious, but that's just my opinion. So if people are trying to say like, oh, like I can use a vape pen because it's safer, we will talk about that a little more. But I'm sure you will hear that, especially if you have a teenager and they're trying to like con you into buying them one for Christmas. It's probably because they're trying to say it's safer. Let's just say you have a teenager who wants you to buy them a vape pen. I want to propose that you buy them something else instead. Maybe they will not be as thrilled as a vape pen, which is on their Christmas list. But I think as a parent, you might be a little happier with this choice. So if your kid likes to read, you know, and also vape, but you prefer them to read, then you can get them something that is a little bit better for Christmas. I want to propose to all listeners out there that you all look into Audible. And right now, for a limited time, you can get 3 months of Audible for just $6.95 a month, which is more than half off of the regular price. So if you want to get this for anyone in your family, or even just give yourself the gift of listening, you know, just treat yourself, you can. And you can get this for this great price if you go to audible.com/GSMCHealth, or you can text GSMCHealth to 500-500. GSMC Health is all one word. And again, that is audible.com/GSMCHealth or text GSMCHealth to 500-500. If you have that person who, you know, is a little difficult on their list, I just want to say you can give them Audible. So thank you all for listening. And we're going to take a break and then we will come back and keep talking about vaping.
Still on the search of that one true love? On the limbo in this crazy world of dating, marriage, relationships? Well, listen to the Golden State Media Concepts Relationship Podcast, your one-stop podcast for everything about relationships.
Welcome back to the GSMC Health and Wellness Podcast. We are continuing to talk about vaping. And before the break, I mentioned the discussion of if vape pens are actually healthier for you. And I just want to bring it back to something that I said before the break. So while vape pens do have aerosols in them, and those aerosols can contain toxins, even trace heavy metals, those are at levels that are permissible in inhalants. And there are also potentially harmful chemicals in vape pens that are not found in tobacco smoke, but the government has declared that those, that even though they're not found in tobacco smoke and they're harmful chemicals, they're still permissible because they are, the concentrations are lower than the safety stand, than the standard. So like if the standard is like 2%, they're trying to say like, oh, is it like 1% or 1.5 or 1.9? And as I mentioned, that's why, because they meet those safety standards that people can still like go out and vape in public places and things like that, because it's not considered dangerous to the health of the person who's vaping or people around you. Like how, you know, there's like secondhand smoking and you're only allowed to smoke in certain designated areas. That's why they're saying that you can publicly vape, because the chemicals are still considered lower than the standard. Even though, as I will stress again, there are harmful chemicals in vape pens, but they're considered lower than standard, and hence they're okay. Chemical concentrations may exceed like stricter public safety limits. So like if you're going on a website that is really strict about like a certain chemical, it's possible that your pods might have those in them, in the little aerosol liquid in there. Just because like maybe one standard somewhere is different from like the general more accepted standard. Kind of like how organic food might be different. How those who support organic food are saying that, well, when you look at standard food, that doesn't match our standards for organic. It's kind of similar to that. Also, more information about vape pens is the device relies on batteries to power the heating elements, and those are made of various materials that aerosolize the liquid. And as you've already mentioned, like that's called like the e-juice or whatever. As I've mentioned, not all contain nicotine, but some do. And again, that's probably why kids aren't smoking the ones with nicotine, but you know, we'll get into that a little bit later about getting the type with nicotine or without. E-cigarettes have been investigated by addiction researchers as possible devices for adults to quit smoking regular cigarettes. And the Food and Drug Administration, or the FDA, lists 93 harmful or potentially harmful chemicals that are found in regular cigarettes. And the National Cancer Institute, or NCI, describes cigarettes as having more than 7,000 chemicals in them. E-cigarettes contain fewer chemicals, and so the industry has presented them as a healthier alternative to cigarettes. But as I said, vape liquid can still contain nicotine, and in case you didn't know, nicotine is considered a highly addictive drug. So while they may contain fewer chemicals than cigarettes, they do still have chemicals, and they can still have nicotine, but they are considered safer. Vape devices have not been proven to help adult smokers quit smoking, but on the other hand, on like the negative side, I would say, because you know, the idea about vape pens maybe or maybe not helping people quit is kind of just like a neutral, I would say, but the negative side of vape pens is that vaping can increase the risk that a teen will smoke regular cigarettes later. Kind of like if a teenager is vaping now at 16, they have a much higher chance of smoking normal, regular, combustible cigarettes later in their life. Once, you know, maybe they turn 18 and they can actually buy them for themselves, they are way more likely to start smoking cigarettes because they vaped. So addiction to nicotine and like later conversion or like dual use with cigarettes is a really big concern for a lot of people in the medical field. That sentiment comes from Roy S. Urbist, who is a doctor at the Yale Medicine, chief of medical oncology at the Yale Cancer Center. And many e-cigarette users get even more nicotine than they would in a vape pen than they would from a tobacco product. And that's because you can buy extra strength cartridges, which have a higher concentration of nicotine. Or you can increase the e-cigarette's voltage or get a greater hit of the nicotine in the e-juice. And some vape brands contain other chemicals. Some of them, as I've said, we don't know all of the chemicals in e-liquid because they can vary by brand. But some of them even contain formaldehyde, which is often used in building materials, or another ingredient that's used in antifreeze. And that's one of the reasons why the Yale Cancer Center is looking into vape pens, because as I said earlier, they're pretty new, so people are concerned about what that might be. Also, flavors in e-cigarettes cause some concern. as I've said, like, they don't necessarily always know what all of the chemicals are. And because you can have such a diversity of flavors or a diversity of types of e-liquids and different brands, there's not really a consistency. There are general ingredients that they all have, but they can vary. Like, some of them can use, like, buttery tasting. Like some of them will be like, oh, like popcorn. There's a buttery tasting chemical called dicetyl. And when it's inhaled, it can be dangerous. So doctors are concerned about that because, like, as I've mentioned, you can increase the voltage of your vape pen. And that way you're, like, inhaling more of the chemicals that are in your pen. Dicetyl is a well-known harmful chemical, and among other things, it can cause a lung disease. And this is like darkly funny. It's called popcorn lung because it has that like buttery flavor. And that comes from Erica Sword, who is an assistant vice president for the national advocacy at the American Lung Association. So professionals are concerned about the chemicals that come in vape pens, and understandably so, I would say. So if we want to look at other things related to vape pens, there are different brands, and there is a particular brand that is very popular and that appeals a lot to young people. So one particular brand called the Juul is a pod mod device, and it's worrying to addiction researchers. So Juuls arrived late to the e-cigarette market back in 2015. And about 18 years after vaping devices first began appearing in the United States. But the company, which is called Juul Labs, has surged ahead of other competitors. And I think also kind of like how Kleenex became a name for like any sort of facial tissue. It's like how Juul Labs, the company, if you just say Juul, everyone knows that that is a vape pen. That's how synonymous it has become. And because it's very popular. Back in August, Juul accounted for 72% of the e-cigarette market. And these vape pens look sleek, they're slim, and as I've mentioned, I see ones that look all the time like USB drives. These are typically the kind that look like USB drives. They're very sleek, which really appeals to the millennials and like the young people. That's like the aesthetic that I think people are after. Like, as I've mentioned, kind of as a joke, I think sometimes they look like piccolos, like some vape pens do. These do not. These are very sleek. They're like an iMac, but for a vape pen. Juul has been established among youth as a vaping tool of choice, and it has morphed into a verb, like you're juuling. That's according to a lot of teens. And this is a quote. When we asked teens about their vaping or e-cig habits, they don't even consider juuling to be part of that. And that comes from Suchitra Krishan Sarin, who's a PhD and co-leader of the Yale Tobacco Center for Regulatory Science. And that's one of 14 centers in the country funded by the National Institute of Health and the FDA to foster tobacco regulatory research. And it is possible to buy liquid without nicotine for e-cigarettes, as I've already mentioned. It's not possible to do so with popular pod mod devices. And according to the Juul's website, in a description, and the description has since been taken down, a single Juul pod contains 40 milligrams of nicotine, which is similar to the nicotine yield of a pack of cigarettes. The company also sells Juul pods with approximately 23 megagrams of nicotine. But researchers explain that it's difficult to describe a single pod as a serving. And a person might consume one pod a week, but then another person might consume like one pod a day. So if Juul Labs is selling a Juul pod that contains 40 milligrams of nicotine, that is similar to one pack of cigarettes. So if you're smoking one Juul pod a day, you're basically smoking a pack of cigarettes a day based on nicotine consumption. And as I've said before, like the pod here, they call it the Juul pod. That is a little cartridge that you put inside your vape pen to smoke. And that's the liquid that you are inhaling. So that liquid can contain the amount of nicotine that is like the same as a pack of cigarettes. And that is insane. That just blew my mind that like some kid can get a Juul and basically smoke a pack of cigarettes just so they can like blow clouds and blow little like smoke rings. That's kind of crazy. And I'm really glad that people are researching this right now. So before we go into a break, I just want to mention something Just as we continue talking about vape pens, I kind of want to bring it up into something that's more positive because I find this topic a little depressing, and it also reminds me of how unhip I am because I don't vape. Christmas is coming up, and I think it's really important to get gifts for everyone on your list, but there's always someone who's difficult. Or maybe Christmas is coming up and you want to buy yourself a gift, which you should. You should treat yourself. And lucky for you, there is a limited time offer where you can get 3 months of Audible for just $6.95 a month. And that's more than half off the regular price. So you can give yourself the gift of listening and give it to someone else on your list. For this great deal, you can go to audible.com/GSMCHealth, or you can text GSMCHealth to 500-500. GSMC Health is one word. And once again, that is audible.com/GSMCHealth, or you can text GSMC Health to 500-500 to claim this wonderful deal. And treat yourself and treat others on your list to a wonderful Christmas gift. So we are going to take a quick break and then we will be right back.
Tired of searching the vast jungle of podcasts? Now listen close and hear this out. There's a podcast network that covers just about everything that you've been searching. Hey! The Golden State Media Concepts Podcast Network is here. Nothing less than a podcast bliss with endless hours of podcast coverage. From news, sports, music, fashion, cooking, entertainment, fantasy, football, and so much more. So stop lurking around and go straight out to the Golden State Media Concepts Podcast Network. Guaranteed to fill that podcast itch. Whatever it may be. Visit us at www.gsmcpodcast.com. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter. And download us on iTunes, SoundCloud, and Google Play.
Welcome back to the GSMC Health and Wellness Podcast. We are continuing to talk about the wonderful topic of vaping. So as I've mentioned before the break, we were talking about Juul and Juul pods and how popular that brand of e-cigarettes is, and also how much nicotine they can contain in one Juul pod. I wanted to just clarify this in case you weren't aware. Nicotine is not good for you. If you didn't know, nicotine is bad for you. And I just want to say there is a lot of research that shows that the adolescent brain is extremely sensitive to nicotine. The brain itself doesn't stop growing until around age 25, and studies have shown that nicotine can interfere with memory and attention processing. Nicotine also raises your blood pressure and it spikes your adrenaline, and all of that can increase your heart rate and the likelihood of having a heart attack. So if you're young and your brain doesn't and if your brain does not stop developing until the age of 25 and you're bringing nicotine into your body, your chances of it harming you and it harming your memory are way higher because your brain is still developing, but you're harming it as it's trying to grow. So if you didn't know this already, nicotine is bad. Please don't smoke. And if you're really young, please don't smoke. Don't pick up vaping. It's really not that cool. So since I've said that, are there regulations? Well, on November 15th, the Food and Drug Administration announced a series of restrictions that were aimed at combating flavored e-cigarettes and tobacco products, and products that have specifically lured young people into vaping and smoking. In a bold move, the agency said it would move to outlaw two traditional tobacco products, menthol cigarettes and flavored cigars. And the proposed menthol ban would be the most aggressive action the FDA has taken against the tobacco industry in nearly a decade. And some other reason for that is menthol is a very popular flavor. So they're trying to cut that back so that youth basically will not pick up smoking because it has a menthol flavor. Menthol is kind of like the minty flavor you get in cough drops sometimes. That's a very popular flavor. So the effort to cut off access to e-cigarettes stopped short of a ban that the stopped short of the ban that the FDA had threatened. It sought to persuade e-cigarette makers like Juul Labs to drop marketing strategies that would appeal to minors. The agency said it would allow stores to continue selling the flavored products like menthol, but only from closed off areas that would be inaccessible to teenagers. And they're hoping that would stop teens from buying them because they wouldn't have direct access to these flavors. But again, like the FDA threatened to do a lot, but with like the ban, they didn't really complete that because they're not saying they can't sell it. They're just saying they want to put it in different areas. Kind of like if you ever, I mean, as I've already said, I'm not that cool, so I'm aware of Blockbuster. But if you ever grew up going to a Blockbuster, there was always like the adult section, maybe not Blockbuster. But if you went to like a DVD rental place, there was a section of adult movies that you were not allowed to walk into if you weren't like over 18. Kind of like there was just like a curtain there and, you know, the clerk was just leering at you and making sure you didn't go back there. That's kind of like what they're saying here, is they just want to sell them in a different location. And again, so the ban's not getting rid of them, which is kind of what people thought the FDA might try and do. There is still a plan to sequester flavored e-cigarettes in stores rather than ban selling them. And people were surprised because the proposal was strong, and the proposal was actually leaked from the agency before they came out officially with their ban. So people thought that this would be a lot stronger than it was because of the rumors that had come. And they were praising the agency for the ban, but really it didn't materialize as they were hoping. Juul Labs, which again, as I said, is the largest e-seller, said that the agency's plans would not change its decision. It announced this week to suspend store sales of its flavored pods, except for mint, methanol, and tobacco, and to shut down its social media promotions. In addition, the company said it would toughen its online age verification requirements, but it left the door open to resume sales at thousands of convenience stores and gas stations and other outlets. If retailers use age verification technology, like scanning customer IDs, they're basically just putting that all into the hands of convenience stores. So even though the government had rumors, like there was rumors they were going to give this big ban, and it didn't really materialize as strong as people thought, Juul Labs is still trying to curb youth desire for vaping products. You know, like as I said, a better age verification online, but they still have them in stores. And that kind of all comes down to how the store wants to regulate and how strict they're going to be. And basically, you know, like when you go to the gas station, how well is someone watching you, you know, because you can go to the gas station and buy these Juul pods there, like how you can buy cigarettes. So I would say e-cigarettes and cigarettes in general, like there's already a law saying that anyone under 18 can't buy them, like the ones with nicotine and all that. I'm not sure if you're under 18 if you can buy them if they don't have nicotine, but you're still, no one under 18 is supposed to be buying nicotine at all. So really, I just say I think that there is a law that you can't buy it if you're under 18, but it could be stricter. There could be a better way to regulate it, despite what Juul Labs said they want to try and do to discourage youth. And if you are young and under 25, you should probably not be smoking because your brain is still developing and nicotine is not good for you. And if you are trying to quit smoking by smoking a vape pen, I would say be careful, because sometimes people just end up like vaping and smoking cigarettes. Like they're not necessarily cutting themselves off completely from cigarettes, and that's not better for you. So I would say if you are trying to quit, I support you, and I hope that you can succeed. And if that takes maybe a short time when you're vaping and then you quit everything, go for it. Again, if you're young, please don't vape. It's not that cool. Please don't do it. So I hope those facts can be a little helpful for you all. And thank you all for listening. I hope you can tune in to the next Health and Wellness episode.
You've been listening to the Golden State Media Concepts Health and Wellness Podcast, part of the Golden State Media Concepts Podcast Network. You can find this show and others like it at www.gsmcpodcast.com. Download our podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, SoundCloud, and Google Play. Just type in GSMC to find all the shows from the Golden State Media Concepts Podcast Network, from movies to music, from sports to entertainment, and even weird news. You can also follow us on Twitter and on Facebook. Thank you, and we hope you have enjoyed today's program.